You probably have heard about this week, that Republican vice presidential candidate Paul Ryan was forced to backpedal from a glaring bit of hypocrisy after it was revealed that he had sought millions of dollars in stimulus funds for his district, despite publicly repeatedly denouncing the 2009 Recovery Act as, quote, a wasteful spending spree. In relation to the Recovery Act, Ryan has forcefully denounced even the underlying basic concept of Keynesian economics, the idea that during a recession or depression, the government can boost economic recovery through spending, sometimes deficit spending. Here he is in July 2010 making just that argument.
Too many are searching for answers in the discredited economic playbook of borrow and spend Keynesian policies. I reject the false premise that only forceful and sustained government intervention in the economy can secure this country's renewed prosperity. Adherence to this premise has given us a damaging policy mixture. It has sparked government spending spree and borrowing binge with no one in sight. Workers, taxpayers, and families across this country have been guinea pigs in this neo-Keynesian experiment long enough. The results are in. Washington's economic experiment has failed.
All right, so no Keynesian economics, borrow and spend, deficit spending to boost recovery and jobs during a period of an output gap when you're in a recession. All that's bad, not just bad, but just conceptually broken, fundamentally conceptually broken. As it turns out, Paul Ryan's request for millions of dollars in Recovery Act spending is only the tip of the iceberg when it comes to his hypocrisy on stimulus. Reviewing old tapes of Ryan this week, we turned up video of Ryan in which he does far more than advocate for one specific stimulus spending item, but actually makes a full-throated, no-holds-barred argument at length for the basic concept of Keynesian stimulus. Government spending to create jobs. Deficit government spending to create jobs. In 2002, with President Bush in the White House, as the country went through the post-9/11 recession, Ryan made a powerful, unapologetic case for the government to step in with a $120 billion stimulus package, including not just tax cuts and tax incentives for business investment, but also an extension of unemployment benefits and health insurance benefits. Here's a look at some of that video from February 14, 2002, in which Congressman Ryan argues on the House floor that government spending has historically created jobs and that unemployment insurance and health insurance are necessary even after economic recoveries begin.
What we are trying to accomplish today with the passage of this third stimulus package is to create jobs and help the unemployed. Now, I've just recently read in our local Capitol Hill newspaper that members from the majority party and the other body want stimulus. They're breaking with their party leadership and asking for stimulus legislation to pass because in their home states, they have a lot of people who are losing their jobs. What we're trying to accomplish is to pass the kinds of legislation that when they've passed in the past, have grown the economy and gotten people back to work. We want to make it easier for employers to keep people employed. We want to make it easier for employers to invest in their businesses, to invest in their employees, and to hire people back to work. And on top of it, for those people who have lost their jobs, we want to help them with their unemployment insurance and with health insurance. What we're trying to accomplish here is a recognition of the fact that in recessions, unemployment lags on even well after a recovery has taken place.
You guys get all that? You get all that? You get the full thing there? Because in the same House session, now, Ryan, when he was, when he's talking about the majority in the other House, he's talking about Senate Democrats who are helping President George W. Bush pass a stimulus because they think it's the best thing to do, even though their partisan interest might be to destroy the agenda of the president from the other party. But the Senate Democrats went for the stimulus. All right, so in the same House session, Ryan even argues, he argues that those worried about fiscal discipline and deficits, right, because all this is borrowed money that they're going to spend for the stimulus, should still support the stimulus because it will get the economy going again, which will then lead to a rise in revenue, smaller deficits, and extended solvency for programs like Medicaid and Medicare down the road.
We have a lot of laid off workers and more layoffs are occurring. And we know as a historical fact that even if our economy begins to slowly recover, that unemployment is going to linger on and on and on well after that recovery takes place. What we have been trying to do, starting in October, then in December, and now, is to try and get people back to work. The things we're trying to pass in this bill are the time-tested, proven, bipartisan solutions to get businesses to stop laying off people, to hire people back, and to help those people who've lost their jobs. It's more than just giving someone an unemployment check. It's also helping those people with their health insurance while they've lost their jobs. And more important than just that unemployment check is to do what we can to give people a paycheck. We've got to get the engine of economic growth growing again, because we now know, because of a recession, we don't have the revenues we wanted to. We don't have the revenues we need to fix Medicare, to fix Social Security, to fix these issues. We've got to get Americans back to work. Then the surpluses come back. Then the jobs come back. That is the constructive answer we're trying to accomplish here on, yes, a bipartisan basis. I urge members to drop the demagoguery and to pass this bill to help us work together to get the American people back to work and help those people who've lost their jobs.
Who is that guy?
Where do I get to wear a pin?
Yeah, you're ready to pull up. And that was not, it was not just the line that Ryan gave in Washington. According to the Wisconsin newspaper, the Journal Times, he goes back to his district and at a town hall meeting with constituents back in his district, he's making the case for Keynesian stimulus spending in much simpler terms. This is what he says. Quote, "You have to spend a little to grow a little. What we're trying to do is stimulate the part of the economy that's on its back." Paul Ryan, 2012, "You have to spend a little to grow a little." No, Paul Ryan, 2002, "You have to spend a little to grow a little." Paul Ryan, 2012, "We hate and reject the failed experiment of Keynesian." I want to talk about this, and I want to talk about the stimulus in the way that it is the absolute bedrock of this kind of political hypocrisy and what it's meant for the era that's followed it right after we take this break. All right, so we just played, I think, a pretty jaw-dropping bit of tape from 2002, and it shows Paul Ryan defending what was then a George W. Bush stimulus to get out of there, and using every single argument of the basic deficit spending argument about stimulus. And I'm just curious, Michael Grumwald, you've written this book that is the most, I think, thorough investigation of the Recovery Act and politics of it and what it did. What is your response when you hear that?
I'm shocked. I do tell the story in the book about how, you know, Republicans, even before Obama took office, had decided that essentially anything Obama stands for, they're going to have to fight. You know, stimulus, you know, Paul Ryan supported the 2002 Bush stimulus. He supported the 2008 Bush stimulus. Right. This was not a controversial topic. In 2008, every presidential candidate, Republican and Democrat, had a stimulus plan. The largest was actually by some guy that you might have heard of. He was the governor of Massachusetts. The name's escaping me. That's right. Yeah, it was $250 billion Mitt Romney's stimulus plan.
And he had the largest stimulus plan.
The largest of all of them. And, you know, Republicans, you know, the $787 billion Obama stimulus, which had tax cuts and spending, was, of course, tyrannical socialism. But there was a Republican substitute that was $715 billion of spending and tax cuts that was apparently good public policy. Right. Paul Ryan voted for that one, too. So this is...
Wait, Paul Ryan wrote for a $750 billion Republican stimulus?
He most certainly did. And there was an interesting argument inside the Republican leadership where the Mike Pence side, you know, the kind of true ideological conservative, said, hey, you know, our stimulus should not be this, you know, we shouldn't be trying to out-New Deal the Democrats. But the Eric Cantors and Paul Ryan said, hey, no, we need to do something that, you know, our moderates can vote for, because the most important thing is to give everybody something to say yes to, so that they can say no to Obama. And and Paul Ryan, of course, fell off both sides of the horse. He voted for the ideological one, and he voted for the political one. And then he went out and trashed the very similar Obama one as, you know, the death of American free enterprise.